Hi, my name is Oveck, and I'm a visual artist from New York City, and today I'm going to give you 5 tips on how to edit some creative portraits. Tip number one would be definitely to don't be afraid to experiment with colors. You can always change things, not because an orange is orange, you know, don't be afraid to change it up and give it a different hue and change things up a little bit. Like, you know, play around with the harmony of the colors. Tip number two will be definitely the midtones, the shadows, and highlights. Play around with those three. Those three would definitely open doors to definitely infinite images and like different feels to the image. So don't be afraid of changing those things around and playing with the colors and the harmony of that. Tip number three, motion blur. Definitely this is something that people always ask me. People ask me on Instagram, people ask me when I meet them and stuff like that. And I go about different ways about doing this, but one way I can go to is I shoot different images, and let's just say I shoot one image at a higher shutter speed, then at a lower shutter speed, and then at a lower shutter speed, and get different motions from the subject, and especially when it comes to portraits. So I do that and then combine them on Photoshop. I do that in a different way, but I can explain that in the next tip. Tip number four, don't be afraid of using Photoshop. Photoshop is a tool. At the end of the day, as a visual artist, I use Photoshop, I use my camera, I use many different things to achieve my goal. So, as I mentioned before, I combine three images together. So, one of the ways that I do that is by creating three layers. And my main layer will be the subject at a normal shutter speed, you know, so that I can add the lower shutter speed to that. And by doing that, I create masks, and I overlay the lower shutter speed to the main picture, the main subject, and create a mask. And with the brush, you can create a mask, and with the brush, you can erase the desire, you know, thing that you want to erase from the image, so that in the end, you create that you know, dreamy movement that people always ask me about. So tip number five, know when to walk away from the image. This is something that I do all the time. I start on an image and it could take me hours, or it could take me 5 minutes. It really depends on the mood. It really depends on many different things. But I know that walking away from it when it's giving me a hard time is really important for the outcome of the image. So please know when to walk away. Don't be afraid of that. All right, so I hope these 5 tips helped you in some way. And you know, if you have any suggestions or any tips or anything that you want to add to this, please, I am more than welcome. Like, I would love to hear it. So please do drop those in the comments sections. And again, find me or my work at any of the platforms, you know, from Instagram to YouTube to whatever. I mean, even my website, oveck.us. And I hope this was in any way help to create a creative portrait. And see you next time.